I'm Thomas, and I'm about to answer the top 5 most frequently asked questions about the Radion XR30 Blue, starting with, what's the difference between the XR30 Blue and the XR30 Pro? The main difference between the Radion Blues and the Radion Pros is the selection of LED colors that are used in each of the fixtures. The Radion Pro uses EcoTech's historically successful combination of cool white, warm white, royal blue, blue, violet, 415 nanometer UV, 405 nanometer UV, green, and photo red to create a well-rounded spectrum with all channels set to 100% that is able to provide corals and other photosynthetic organisms with the energy they require while appearing visually bright and natural. The Radion Blue, on the other hand, focuses much more heavily on the blue spectrum and swaps out the warm white and green diodes for cyan and lime diodes, and instead of a total of 30 white spectrum LEDs, it has just 6, with the other 24 diodes shifted over to the blue end of the spectrum, so that when the Radion Blue has all channels set to 100%, it creates the very popular Coral Labs AB Plus spectrum that many Radion Pro users were tuning their fixtures to by tuning down those whites, reds, and greens. So, for those who prefer that super popular AB Plus spectrum, the Radion Blue means you can turn the fixture up to 100% on all channels and not have to lose any wattage or PAR that you would normally be losing by turning down several channels on the Pro fixtures. How high do you mount the Radion XR30 Blue? The recommended mounting height for Radion fixtures is between 8 inches and 9 inches off of the surface of the water. If you use the RMS mounting system from EcoTech, the arms will hold the fixtures right at that height, so rest assured your Radion will be at the optimal mounting height for the best possible spread and overall PAR performance. Or should I say, PAR-formance? Okay, I'll stop. How do you set up an EcoTech Radion XR30 Blue? Once you get your Radion unboxed, you can attach it to your mounting option of choice, place it over your tank, and then plug it into power. Next, download the Mobius app to your smart device and then create an account and log in. Name your tank and the app will automatically detect any EcoTech devices nearby and they will populate on the screen. You can then tap on the Radion light fixture icon, then the app will walk you through a simple setup starting with what time you'd like the schedule to start and then what time you'd like it to end, followed by what spectrum template you'd like to start with, and since it's a Radion Blue, chances are you're gonna stick with that AB Plus spectrum. Once you confirm your selection, you can see a preview of your schedule and you're all done. Really easy. How do you control the Radion XR30 Blue? You can control your Radion XR30 Blue using the Mobius app on any old Android or iOS smart device. The app allows for both a quick setup like the one we just went over, as well as full-on detailed control of each LED channel, overall intensity, moonlighting, and more to create custom light schedules that can be as complex or as simple as you'd like them to be. The app also offers an acclimation mode so you can temporarily dim your lighting and have it slowly ramp up to the maximum intensity over several days or weeks so that you can comfortably transition new corals to the tank or your current corals to your new Radion lighting. And there are also fun modes like disco so you can show off your crazy cool lighting to your friends and family. How long should LED lights be on in a reef tank? In most cases, a reef tank is going to have somewhere between 9 and 12 hours of daylight over the course of the day, depending on a few factors, including what the maximum intensity of the light is and how long it takes the light to ramp up to and back down from that maximum intensity. But for the average reefer, a 10-hour light cycle that takes 1 hour to ramp from 0% to 100% of the maximum intensity for the sunrise, 8 hours of that maximum intensity for the daylight, and 1 hour ramp down from 100% to 0% for the sunset will be a good length of time that most reefers should be successful with. Just keep in mind that's 100% of the maximum intensity. So if your goal is LPS and soft corals and your Radion only needs to be at 20% overall intensity to provide the right range of PAR for those corals in your tank, when your schedule ramps from 0% to 100% of the maximum intensity, it's actually going from 0% to 20%, staying at 20%, and then ramping back down to 0%. It is a very important distinction to make. The maximum intensity that you set your fixture to, in this case 20%, is separate of the ramping intensity of the actual schedule. So if you set the light to 20% and your schedule ramps from 0 to 100%, it will be a 0 to 100% ramp between actual 0 and 20% maximum intensity, since that's what you capped your fixture to. Hopefully that makes sense. If you want to be able to take full advantage of that Coral Labs AB Plus spectrum and prefer that bluer look to your tank with all of that crazy coral color pop, and the XR30 blues match your reefing mantra, you can pick one up for yourself by clicking right here.